Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in this subject, Operation Research. This is lecture number 2 in the assignment model, module number 3. The topic is assignment model, solution to the assignment model and problem solving in the assignment model. The learning outcome to the students at the end of the lecture, the students will be able to solve problem in the assignment model. In the earlier lecture, we solved 2 problems in the assignment model. Now, the third example, it is unbalanced problem. 5 jobs are to be assigned to 4 machines subject to the cost matrix as shown below. Make the minimum cost assignment. There are 4 machines A, B, C, D and 5 jobs 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the cell values that represent the cost of the job doing in the machine. Now, this is unbalanced problem. The number of rows are 5, number of columns are 4. So, it is unbalanced problem. So, the number of columns are less than number of rows. Add 1 dummy column with the cell value 0. Then now we have the 5 machines now. So, machine E is the dummy machine with the cell value equal to 0. And the job, there are 5 jobs. Now, it is being balanced. Now, checking the row, each row we have 1 0 because the last column has got 0. So, each row has got 1 0. Now, we have to subtract the column. So, in the column A, the lowest value is 2. So, subtract 2 from all the other values, it becomes 7, 4, 3, 2, 0. In the column B, again the minimum value is 2. Subtract 2 from all the other values, 5, 4, 1, 0, 6. Column C, the minimum value is 3. Subtract 3 from all the other values, 3, 4, 1, 2, 0. And the column D, the minimum value is 2. Subtract 2 from all the other values, 0, 4, 2, 7, 4. Column E as it is. So, now we check the value. First row, it has got 2 zeros. All the 5 rows, they have the 0. Column A has got 1, 0. Column B has got 1, 0. Column C has got 1, 0. Column D has got 1, 0 here. Now, we have to make the assignment. So, this is the table matrix again. Assign the job 1 to the machine D. So, job 1 to the machine D. So, it is assigned. And check the column vertically. There is no 0. Assign job 2 to machine E. So, substitute here and cross all the other zeros in the same column. The 3 zeros, 4 zeros are deleted. And assign job 4 to the machine B. So, this is assigned. And assign job 5 to the machine A. So, this is also assigned. And this 0 we have to delete because we cannot make assignment here. Now the assignment is incomplete because job 3 is not assigned, machine C is not allotted any job. So it is incomplete assignment. Now we have to go for the next iteration. So I repeat the table again here. The matrix is shown here again. Now, mark a tick mark in the row where we require assignment. So, row 3, we require the assignment. You tick the mark a tick mark there in the row 3. And mark tick mark in the column which possess 0 in the marked row. So, this is the marked row. Here, we have the E column has got the 0. Mark tick in the column which possess 0 in the marked row, column E. And mark tick mark in the row which possess marked 0, that is row 4. So, first this column, this is the row we require assignment. And here for in this row, this is the column we have 0. In this column, this is the row where we have assignment. So, all the 3 values are marked here. Now, draw lines through the unmarked row and marked column. So, this is marked column, unmarked row are 1. 4, 5. Now, we have the cell values where there is no line crossing. Among the cell values on which line is not passing, the minimum value is 1. So here we have 1. Subtract 1 from all the other cell values and add 1 wherever the line is crossing. So here among the 8 cell values we have to subtract 1 and here we have to add 1. So in the three cell values where the line is crossing we have to add 1 and here the new table. So the new table 73200, 53006, 33020, 03174, 10011. Now we have to make the assignment. For job 1, we assign machine D and vertically look at the table. There is no other 0. And for job 2, we assign machine E. And for job 3, we assign machine C. Job 4, we assign machine B. And job 5, we assign machine A. So all the jobs are assigned and all the machines are engaged and we delete the remaining zeros. Now the assignment is optimum now. The machine assignments are 1 to D, 2 to E, 3 to C, 4 to B and 5 to A. And the optimum cost is 2 plus 0 plus 4 plus 2 plus 2 equal to 10. So it is the optimum cost of assignment. We take another example number 4, it is maximization type of problem. In the earlier 3 problems, what we solved is minimization type of problem and this is maximization type of problem in the assignment. So, assign the job such that the profit is maximum. We have 4 jobs J1, J2, J3, J4 and 4 machines A, B, C, D and the cost of doing the job with the machine A, it is given here. So 62, 78, 50, 101, 71, 84, 61, 73, 87, 92, 111, 71, 48, 64, 87, 77. The Hungarian method what we discussed earlier for assignment solution of assignment problem is applicable only to minimization type of problems. So the given problem should be converted to minimization type of problem by subtracting all the cell values from the highest cell value. So among the 16 cell values, the highest cell value is 111, so which is J3C. So here we have 111. We have to subtract all the other cell values from 111. So doing so, the table value becomes 49, 40, 24, 63, 33, 27, 19, 47, 61, 50, 0, 24, 10, 38, 40 and 34. Now we have to apply the Hungarian method. The given matrix is square matrix. So subtract the minimum cell value of each row from all the other cell values in the same row and applying the condition. So in the first row, the minimum value is 10. So, subtract 10 from all the other values, 39, 23, 51, 0. In the second row, the minimum value is 27. Subtracting 27 from all the other values, 13, 0, 23, 11. Third row, 0 is the minimum value. So, it will be repeated, 24, 19, 0, 40. And in the fourth row, minimum value is 24. Subtract 24 from all the other values, 39, 23, 0, 10. Now looking at the first row, we have 0, second row we have 0, third row we have 0 here and fourth row we have 0. Looking at the column A does not have the 0, column B we have 1, 0, column C we have 2 zeros, column C we have 1, 0. Now we have to identify the minimum value of the column A. 13 is the minimum value, subtract 13 from the remaining cell values. So here we repeated the table again, so subtracting. Column A does not possess a 0, so subtract minimum cell value 13 from all the other cell values. So the resulting table will be 26, 0, 11, 26, 23, 0, 19, 23, 51, 23, 0, 0, 0, 11, 40 and 10. Now we make the assignment, so the table is repeated here. So assign job J1 to the D. And assign job J2 to the A and assign job J3 to C and this 0 will be deleted. Now the assignment is incomplete because J4 is not assigned and machine B is free. So J4 is not assigned and machine B is free. So mark a tick mark in the row where we require assignment. So here we require assignment. For job of J4, we require the assignment. And mark the tick on the column which possess the 0 in the marked row. So here we have the 0 and mark the tick mark in which possess marked 0. J3 is the row. Now we have to draw line. We repeat the table again. The table is repeated here. Now mark line through unmarked rows and marked column. So unmarked row, J1, J2 are the unmarked row. C is the marked column. The number of lines passing through the matrix is 3, where we made 3 assignments. So 3 lines for 3 assignments. Now among the cell values on which line is not passing, the minimum value is 10. So here we have the minimum value. Now subtract 10 from all the other cell values on which line is not passing and add 10 value 10 wherever the line is crossing. So here we have to add 10, here we have to add 10. From the remaining cells, we have to subtract 10. Now, the resulting table 26, 0, 1, 16, 23, 0, 9, 13, 61, 33, 0, 0, 0, 11, 30, 0. Now, we make the assignment job J1 to the machine D, job J2 to the machine A, job J3 to machine C, and all the other values are deleted. Again, the job is assignment is incomplete because J4 is not yet assigned and the machine B is free now. Now we continue with the marking. So mark tick mark in the row J4 row, mark tick mark in the two column where we have 0. So here we have 0, here also we have 0, and tick mark, put tick mark in which possess marked 0. So here in this column we have marked 0 here. And in this column, we have marked 0 here. Now, number of lines passing through is 5. Number of tick mark are 5. We repeat the table again. Now, draw lines through unmarked row and marked column. So, number of lines equal to 3. So, again, there are three assignments and the 3 marked lines are there. Now, among the cell values, the minimum value is 1. Now, here we have the minimum value. So you subtract 1 from all the other values which is on which line is not passing and add 1 wherever the line is crossing. Now adding the 1 value 1, so repeat resulting table. It is a resulting table 25 0 0 15, 22 0 8 12, 61 34 0 0, 0 11 30 1. Now making the assignment J1 to D, J2 to B, J3 to A and J4 to C. So remaining 3 zeros are deleted. So now the assignment is complete. The optimum is assignment J1 to D, J2 to B, J3 to A and J4 to C. And the cost is the optimum cost, that is profit equal to 101 plus 84 plus 87 plus 87 equal to rupees 359. We take another example, example number 5. So this is problem with restriction. So restriction means certain jobs are not assigned to certain machine. 4 jobs are to be assigned with 5 workers. The time of processing is given in the table. Find the optimal assignment to minimize the overall processing time. So there are 4 jobs and 5 machines. And here we have the value. So 6, 8, 12, 7, 8. 9, 6, hyphen. So, hyphen indicates the job J2 cannot be allotted to the worker W3. So, 7, 6. And similarly here, job J3 cannot be allotted to the worker W1. 8, 11, 8, 4. 11, 5, 9, 4, 5. Now, due to restriction, job J2 should not be allotted to the worker W3 and the job J3 should not be allotted to the worker W1. So we assume that processing time for above 2 cells is infinity. The number of rows are less than the number of columns. So it is unbalanced problem. We have to add one more row, dummy row we have to add. So by adding the dummy row and the 2 restricted cell values is marked as infinity. So infinite time. So we added one more row, J5 row is the dummy row with the cell values 0 and all the cell values are 0. Now in the first column, first the subtract minimum cell value in each row from the rest of the cell values in the same row. So taking the J1 row J1, 6 is the minimum value, subtracting 6 from all the other values, 0, 2, 6, 1, 2. In the second, the minimum value is 6, subtracting 6 from all the other values, 3, 0. Infinity minus 6 equal to again infinity. So infinity, 1, 0. And here infinity, the minimum value is 4, infinity, 4, 7, 4, 0. And here the minimum value is 4 again. So 7, 1, 5, 0, 1. And the last row, we have 0. Now checking, first row we have 1 0, second row we have 2 zeros, third row we have 1 0, fourth row we have 1 0, fifth row we have zeros. All the columns they have 1 0 minimum. Now we have to make the assignment. So assign the worker J1, the job J1 to the worker W1. Delete the 0 in the same column. Assign job J2 to the worker W2. Delete 0 in the same column. Assign job J3 to the worker W5 and delete 0 in the same column. Assign job J4 to the worker W4 and delete the 0 in the same column. And assign job J5 to the worker W3. Now the optimum assignment is complete. So all the jobs are assigned to the all the workers. Now the assignment is optimum. The optimum assignments are J1 to W1. J2 to W2, J3 to W5, J4 to W4, and J5 to W3, and the optimal process cost equal to 6 plus 6 plus 4 plus 4 equal to 20. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have published in the mechanical engineering subject. If you find one book, Operation Research, you can refer to the book for additional information on the assignment model. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, listen to the video for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again with another video lecture in the subject Operation Research. Until then, bye bye.